My name is Richard Sause, and I'm the director of the ATLSS Center at Lehigh University. ATLSS stands for the Advanced Technology for Large Structural Systems Center. Well, the challenge of earthquake engineering for structural engineers is the fact that the forces are dynamic and very large, potentially extremely damaging, and they're unlike most of the other forces that we consider, very challenging. Well, we've all seen the damage to buildings and bridges from past earthquakes. At Lehigh, our current research focus in earthquake engineering is on structures that can survive earthquakes with little or no damage. During the past 60 or 70 years, engineers in the United States have made an enormous amount of progress in creating structures that protect people from injury and loss of life during earthquakes. But we've been willing to accept a significant amount of damage. Now we're aiming to reduce the damage and decrease downtime. We'd like to get to the point where if we look at buildings and bridges before and after an earthquake, we'd see no difference. At the ATLSS Center at Lehigh, we're developing a variety of systems that can withstand earthquakes with little or no damage. These systems will include specialized braces, dampers, and other devices that can absorb earthquake energy. We're also developing a next generation of precast concrete structures and steel structures with carefully designed elastic elements that can restore the structure to its original position after the earthquake is over. Well, the most exciting part of the work we're doing at Lehigh currently is on self-centering earthquake-resistant systems. And these are systems that have these carefully designed elastic elements that will restore the structure back to its original condition, regardless of how hard it was shaken during the earthquake. And we're used to seeing buildings and bridges with some permanent leaning or drift after such an earthquake. And in this case, these systems will return them back to their initial condition. So we're really excited about seeing these systems move out into practice and then seeing them subjected to real earthquake shaking in the future. Well, much of our earthquake engineering research at Lehigh is funded by the National Science Foundation through the Network for Earthquake Engineering Simulation Program, which is called the NEES program. Within the NEES program, we're a member of a 15-university consortium that includes Lehigh, University of California, Berkeley, University of Illinois, and other leading earthquake engineering institutions. Lehigh and other members of the NEES consortium are linked to each other and to the rest of the world through Internet too, and this allows us to share data and other information from our experiments in real time. We also have the capability with the RTMD site for users of this site to remotely control certain aspects of our experiments in the lab. As an example of how this works, my colleague Professor Jim Rickles and his collaborators at Lehigh and Illinois recently conducted simultaneous tests at Lehigh and at the University of Illinois. The purpose of these tests was to better understand the response of bridge structures to the 1994 earthquake in Los Angeles, California. To do this, they built a complete model of the bridge, including the bridge superstructure and the piers. The bridge superstructure was simulated numerically in a supercomputer, but the individual piers were replicated at large scale in the lab at Lehigh and at Illinois.